He's like, you'll know when you get there, but that, no, God, I need to know, I need to plug it into my GPS. I need to know exactly how long it's going to take me to get there. I need to make sure I make all the right turns. I got to make sure that I pack all the right baggage, God. The seasons are different and no matter where I go, God, so I need to make sure that I have everything. I need God to say, just go. I'll come back to that later. Verse 2 says, I will make you into a great nation, and I'll bless you, and I'll make your name great. And you will be a blessing. Verse 3 says, I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all the people on the earth will be blessed through you. The promises of God. So we know the story. Abram is a great man of faith. God called him to leave his homeland and go to an unknown destination. And Abraham immediately obeyed. Did question, immediately obeyed. God, you're saying, okay, it's time to go. Let me pack up my stuff. God, you want to reveal to me when I get there? Immediately. Obey. We're talking about trusting the process. Genesis chapter 15, verse 1, it says that after this, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision, told him, do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your very great reward. But Abram said, Sovereign Lord, what can you give me since I remain childless, and the one who will inherit my estate is Eliezer of Damascus? Verse 3 says, and Abram said, you have given me no children, so a servant in my household will be my heir. So immediately, the Lord tells him, do not be afraid. I find that interesting. Why is it interesting? Because there's four items that grow in the waiting room when we're talking about trusting the process. That's fear, that's frustration, that could be faith, or it could be foolishness. Fear, faith, frustration, or foolishness. Those are all things that you can find in any waiting room. You go to any emergency room, you'll find that. You'll go any place where somebody is waiting, and you'll find these four items right there. Fear, faith, foolishness, or frustration. Tell me I'm lying. I'm not lying. So, just earlier, God made a promise to Abram. You will be blessed. And all these things. And the first thing that comes out of his mind said, well, I ain't got an heir. I don't have any children. So what needs to happen is that I guess we have to bless the estate of Eliezer of Damascus. So we spend so much time and energy thinking about what we are missing. And somehow that we're inadequate. When we serve a God that says, that's all that I need. I've already equipped you with everything that you need. You are enough. You have enough. What is in your hand? Look at what he did with those who thought they were lacking, with a little bit of cornmeal and just a little bit of oil and with five loaves and two fish. Look what he did in that situation. Matthew 17:20 says that he replied, because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. We love that scripture. All it takes is a little bit of faith. That's all it takes. A little bit of faith. We stand on that scripture. Oh, yeah. Oh, faith. All I need is faith of a mustard seed. I can move mountains. All this stuff. But one thing you have to realize is that even that faith requires you to face a mountain. You have to be willing to face the mountain. In spite of even having a little bit of faith, it didn't say that just because you have the faith, you still have to face the mountain and speak to the mountain. Yes. We're talking about trust the process. Abram chose to remind God of what he already knows. You give me no heir, so a servant will be my heir. He told the Lord, since you have given me no children, God, this is what I'm going to do. And this is what you should do. See, that due time process is so difficult. When the picture does not look like the promise. There's scripture in the Word of God that says, hope deferred makes the heart sick. And the reason why that means is because we put our hope in so many circumstances and situations where it allowed us to be sick. We put our hope in people, and people let us down. You put your hope in a job, and a job lets you down. You put your hope in an economy, and an economy will let you down. You put your hope in all these different things, and they will always let you down. But God said, your hope needs to be placed in me. Amen. Because when your hope is out of place, then it makes the heart sick. So I want to ask you this, like Abram. So what is your plan when you feel like God is taking too long? I want you to answer that. I know there's something that you're waiting for right now. So what is your plan when you feel like God is taking too long? What is your contingency plan? Your alternative plan that you're willing to accept when the weight gets too hard? What substitute are you willing to accept versus waiting for the real thing? I went to a restaurant the other day and they said, okay, how can I help? They said, well, I'd like a Coke. And they said, well, we have Pepsi. I said, okay, I'll give a Sprite. So I see here and miss. I said, brother, do you know a Coke is not Pepsi? And Sprite is not Sierra Mist. It is not the same thing. It's not an equal substitute. So my question to you is, if God wants to offer you some Sprite, are you willing to accept Sierra Mist if it takes too long? It looks the same. Same color can. It's close enough. And that's many believers right now in every churches are all across America that they're walking around with something they think is a blessing, but it's close enough. God, this is close enough, God, for what you have promised me. It's not actually what he promised. It's just, it kind of resembles what God has. That people get in relationships that resemble what God wants for them. There's people who take jobs that resemble what God wants them to do. There's people who start ministry and it resembles what God truly wants to do in their life. And we walk around in a place and we just realize, we think that we are original. God said, no, you're actually just a substitute. I never called you to be a substitute. I called you to be the real thing. But see, when we get in a situation, we're talking about trust the process and the wait gets too long, that's when we start making those critical errors. Right. You never want to move faster than God is moving. Right. Verse 4 says that, then the word of the Lord came to him. This man will not be your heir, but a son who is your own flesh and blood will be your heir. It says he took him outside and said, look up at the sky and count the stars. If indeed you can count them, then he said to him, so shall your offspring be. Verse 6 says, Abram believed the Lord, and he credited to him as righteousness. It said Abraham believed the promise, and it's counted to him as righteousness. It said he believed them. My struggle with this verse was that he believed them, but yet he never got an answer on when he would fulfill the promise. Abram, listen, I told you I'm going to do it. Let's go outside. You can see I've already spoken. I already promised it to you. Okay, God, I believe you. But when? God just confirmed it. So he believed the promise. Yet the Lord had not revealed the timing of the request. Lord, why would you encourage me, then not tell me when you're going to do it? Lord, I want to know when. This is what I've been waiting on. We're talking about trusting the process. Point number one that I have today is that if you want to grow in godliness, you must grow in patience as well. If you want to grow in godliness, you must grow in patience as well. Think about that. God, I want you to be pleased in every area of my life. God said, okay. God, I want to be a man of faith. Okay, I believe you. But there's some things that you have to go through to surely show, do you have the goods? Are you willing to stick it out? Because God is not going to, he's not interested in putting elevating substitutes. There's enough of them in the world today. God wants to make sure real deal, authentic. Isaiah chapter 40 verse 31 says, but those who who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. Wait, they will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. Why renew strength if there wasn't an opportunity to get tired? He would not have to tell you, would not have to talk about renewing strength if there was not an opportunity for you to get fatigued. Amen. Waiting is not always easy. I'm not here to say that waiting is easy, but I'm here to tell you that waiting is worth it. But that's why God promises that if you trust me, if you submit your life to me, that if you wait, I will renew your strength. So when you get tired, God says, I'm right here. Hey, I'll confirm it again. I'm not going to tell you when, but I'm going to tell you that it still is a go. The green light is still for you. But you have to wait. But God, tell me when. No, you have to wait. I'm not going to tell you when, but I will give you the strength that you need to endure the waiting process. Genesis chapter 16, verse 1 says, now Sarai, Abram's wife, had borne him no children, but she had an Egyptian slave named Hagar. Verse 2 says, so she said to Abram, the Lord has kept me from having children. Go sleep with my slave. Perhaps I can build a family through her. A lack of faith is contagious. It's contagious. And that's why it truly is important of who you're surrounding yourself with. People who are going to encourage you in the faith, because I know sometimes it's hard. But see, sometimes we go through things and we want people to feel sorry for us. And we get on our old soapbox and sometimes you want to just talk and talk and talk. And you want someone to pull out the violin and play the violin and create a soundtrack to your sorrow. And we rehearse it all the time. What are you listening to? It's the soundtrack to my sorrow, soundtrack to my life, ups and downs. You need people who are going to encourage you. We're going to hold you accountable. People who are going to say, you know what, don't throw in the towel right now.